हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेकंड चैप्टर, दैट इज माइक्रो इनकैप्सुलेशन टेक्निक्स एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशंस। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय माइक्रो इनकैप्सुलेशन, व्हाट आर द फंडामेंटल कंसीडरेशन, व्हाट इज द रीजन और नीड ऑफ माइक्रो इनकैप्सुलेशन, वेरियस टेक्निक्स ऑफ माइक्रो इनकैप्सुलेशन एंड एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ माइक्रो इनकैप्सुलेशन। फर्स्ट वील सी व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय माइक्रो इनकैप्सुलेशन। Microencapsulation is nothing but a process by which very tiny droplets or particles of liquid or solid material are surrounded or coated with a continuous film of polymeric material, and the product obtained by this process ranges in the size 50 to 1000 micron, and the product obtained is called as microcapsules. Now, fundamental consideration. Generally, microparticles or microcapsules consist of two components. First is core material and second is coating material. Coating material may be also called as wall material or shell material. So, coating material is nothing but the material which is to be coated. It may be a liquid, solid, or may be a gas. Liquid core may be dissolved or dispersed material. Core material is generally composed of drug and active constituents, additives like diluents and stabilizers. Coating material, it is an inert substance which generally coat on the core with desired thickness. Normal composition of coating material, it contains polymers which form a continuous film over the core. Second is plasticizer, which act as a flexibility inducing agent or incorporating agent, coloring agent, it may be as per the requirement, various resins, waxes and lipids, they may be used for coating as well as for polishing also, and release rate enhancers or retardants. The choice of release rate enhancers and retardant depend on what kind of product we require and what is our main objective of preparing microcapsules. Means if you want to sustain the release, then release retardant we can add. If you want to quick or what we can say enhance the release rate, then release rate enhancers we can use. Examples of coating material. Number of coating material can be used for microencapsulation, same as that of tablet. They are according to their properties divided or classified. First, water soluble polymers means when we want to coat the particles for test masking or odor masking or just to improve the elegance, then generally we are using water soluble polymers like gelatin, gum arabic, starch, etc. And when we want to sustain the action or retard the release of drug, then generally we are using the water insoluble polymers like ethyl cellulose, polyethylene, polymethacrylates, etc. Same is the case waxes and lipids, they also can be coated for prolonging the action as well as for polishing. For example, paraffin, carnauba wax, beeswax, stearic acid, etc. Also, enteric coating polymers can be used for microencapsulation like shellac, cellulose acetate, phthalate. So these polymers are generally used to target the distal part of GIT, that is colon. So here a summary of microencapsulation. So in microencapsulation, core material used or used are generally solid, liquid or maybe gas. Coating material used, they may be polymer, vaccines, resins, proteins or polysaccharides. And vehicles used, they may be aqueous or non-aqueous. Now, reasons for coating or microencapsulation or need of microencapsulation. The core material must be isolated from its surroundings. So, what is the need of isolation? Generally, isolation is carried out to protect the reactive substances from the environment. Like if our drug or API is susceptible to oxidation, then we have to coat it to prevent its oxidation. Then to convert liquid active component into dry solid system, as we know that handling of solid is much easier as compared to handling of liquids. Then to separate incompatible components for functional reasons. We know that more than one active ingredient we are giving in a same dosage form. So as we are increasing number of chemicals, the chances of incompatibility are more. So with the help of microencapsulation, we can give number of chemicals in a single dosage form without physical contact. So that is the main advantage. Then next it is to control release of active ingredient for delayed release or for long acting release, means sustained release. Masking the taste and odor of the core, it is also possible by microencapsulation to increase the bioavailability. Now how we can increase the bioavailability? See, some drugs are unstable in the gastric acidic conditions. So such drug, if you coat by a polymer which is insoluble in acidic condition, so definitely more amount of drug will reach to the small intestine and more amount of drug will be bioavailable. Next reason may be to produce a targeted drug delivery. Like when we want to target the distal part of GIT, like colon, then enteric coating may be done and we can target the colon. Next reason for encapsulation is to protect the GIT from irritant effect of drug and vice versa. Means we can protect the GIT from the irritant effect of drug, as well as we can protect the drug from the hazardous effect of the acidic conditions of stomach. Here are some examples of core material and their purpose of encapsulation. First, aspirin. It is slightly water soluble solid and it is generally microencapsulated for test masking, sustained release or reduce its gastric irritation. And final product is tablet or a capsule. Vitamin A palmitate, it is also microencapsulated and it is a non-volatile liquid. So, and it is susceptible to oxidation. So to stabilize it against the oxidation, it can be microencapsulated. Next example is isosorbide dinitrate. It is water soluble solid and to convert it into a sustained release or slow release, we can go for microencapsulation. Then third point is methods of manufacturing of various microcapsules. There are number of methods available for microencapsulation and the choice of microencapsulation method depends on physical and chemical properties of material to be encapsulated. So while choosing a proper method, we must consider various points such as the stability and biological activity. Means the stability and biological activity of drug should not be affected, as well as the yield and the drug encapsulation efficiency should be high. Microsphere quality and drug release profile should be reproducible within specified limits. Microsphere should not exhibit aggregation or adherence. And the chosen method, it must be usable for at the industrial scale. The residual level of organic solvent should be lower than the limited value. So here are the methods available for microencapsulation. They are categorized into physical or physico-mechanical methods, physico-chemical methods and chemical methods. In physical methods, air suspension, centrifugation, pan coating, spray drying and so on. In physico-chemical, ionotropic gelation and co-observation phase separation method. In chemical, solvent evaporation, polymerization and so on, many methods are available. First, we'll see physical method, in that air suspension coating. This method is invented by Professor Del E. Wooster. Basically, the process of Wooster consists of a dispersing of solid particulate core material in a supporting air stream and the spray coating of the air suspended particles. Equipment ranging in capacities from 1 pound to 990 pounds. Micron or submicron particles can be effectively encapsulated by air suspension technique. Main disadvantage of this technique is that during coating process there may be chances of agglomeration and it result into a larger size of particles. And another disadvantage is that in this method we can coat only solid materials. This is diagrammatic representation of air suspension apparatus. Already we have seen this, or we have studied this in tablet coating. Same type of apparatus is used here. Next method is multi-orifice centrifugation. In this technique we will see the design of apparatus used. So it contains mainly a rotating drum which have three grooves. Upper and lower grooves are meant for the holding of coating solution, and central groove, it has a small opening, it is called as a orifice. This drum is continuously rotating, and at the axis of this drum there is a rotating disc, and in this technique core particles are poured onto this rotating disc, and due to spinning action of the disc with the help of centrifugal force, the core particles are thrown towards the orifice where a film of coating solution already exists. The coated particles are dried in a controlled conditions, means when the particles are passing through a orifice where a film of coating solution is there, so it get coated with a coating solution, and when we collecting this particle in a controlled environment or conditions like high temperature and low humidity, then these particles get dried, means solvent get evaporated and core material get coated with the polymer. Next technique is pan coating. It is same as that of tablet coating. It is the oldest industrial process for forming of small coated particles or tablets. But main disadvantage of this technique is that only larger size particles, larger than 600 micron, they can be coated into this pan coating method. Again, the process and operation and principle already we have discussed in chapter tablet coating. Next method is spray drying and spray congealing. First we'll see spray drying. In this method, the coating solidification affected by rapid evaporation of solvent in which coating material is either dissolved or dispersed. Dispersion of coating material into coating solution is sprayed into a hot air chamber where a solvent get evaporated and polymer get coated on core particles. Means first we are preparing a coating solution, in that we are dispersing a solid core material or maybe liquid core material, that we are spraying into hot environment or hot conditions. So in hot condition what will happen, the solvent will get evaporated and our polymer get coated around the core material and we get the micro capsules. Next method is spray congealing. This method, the principle of this method is nearly same as that of spray drying. And spray congealing can be accomplished with spray drying equipment itself. But in this method, what is the change? The core material is dispersed in coating material melt rather than a coating solution. Means when we want to coat the waxy material or waxes, then this waxes must be first melt. And in this molten liquid, we have to disperse the core material, and this dispersion we have to spray in controlled environment. So controlled environment here means in cool air we have to spray. In cool air the wax gets solidified and we get a coated core material, that is micro capsules.